Birds were uniquely created for us to enjoy. Understanding the different parts of the birds will help you to identify them more accurately. When attempting to identify a bird, you will need to note the colors, patterns, sizes, and lengths of these parts. You will also need to note the bird's size as a whole, its voice, its flight, its posture, how it walks or hops, its habitat, and where you saw it. For example, habitats include forest, marshes, deserts, meadows, mountains, etc. This information will help you to identify the bird using a field guide or by giving its description to an expert birder. Let's begin with an overview of basic bird anatomy. The cap, or crown, refers to the top of the head of a bird. A commonly known North American bird is the black-capped chickadee. Its name is derived from the fact that it has a black cap. In some cases, you may see a crest on a bird. The blue jay and Steller's jay are two examples of crested birds. Some birds can raise or lower their crest. The bill, or beak, refers to the part that the bird uses to eat. Bills and beaks come in various lengths, shapes, and sizes. Birds of prey, such as eagles, have deeply hooked bills for ripping apart flesh, while hummingbirds have long beaks for reaching far into flowers. Each bill is unique to suit its purpose. The neck, or nape, refers to the back of the part just below the head of the bird. The neck of a bird is composed of 13 to 25 cervical vertebrae, thus enabling birds to have increased flexibility. Birds that don't have neck feathers, such as the ostrich and vulture, are able to tolerate heat better in hot climates. The cheek refers to the side of the head of a bird. Two examples of distinguishing cheeks in the bird world are the green-cheeked conure, with dark green cheeks, and the cockatiel, that has bright orange patches on its cheeks. The throat refers to the front of the part just below the head of the bird. Some of the most fascinating throats belonging to birds are those of the hummingbirds. In the world of hummingbirds, throat colors vary from red, purple, black, pink, blue, green, and on females, white. The back is fairly self-explanatory. In identification, noticing the color and pattern of the back of a bird is essential. The breast and belly refer to two parts. The breast is located just below the throat, and the belly is located just below the breast. Markings and colors on these two parts are extremely helpful in the identification of birds. An American robin's breast and belly are orange. The wing bar refers to a section on the wing of a bird. Wing bars or patches are also very useful for identification. Red-winged blackbirds have a red patch bordered with yellow or a yellow bar below. The wing refers to the part that enables birds to fly. Wing shapes vary in birds from long, narrow, pointed and broad, to rounded, fingered, and short. Wings may also have patterns that will help in identifying species. The flank refers to the side part that is between the belly and the wing. Flanks can be hard to see depending on how the bird carries its wings. However, the flanks may have markings that will help you in identification. The tufted titmouse has distinct, rusty-colored flanks. The rump refers to the part that is between the back and the tail. The color of the rump is sometimes used by ornithologists to distinguish between species, or between males and females of the same species. The yellow-rumped warbler has a distinct yellow rump. The foot refers to the part that the bird uses to walk. Most waterfowl have webbed feet, enabling them to swim. Some, such as the American coot, don't have webbed feet, but are still able to swim because they have fleshy lobes on their toes. Most birds have three front toes and one rear toe. However, the ostrich only has two front toes. The tail refers to the part hanging off the back of the bird. By watching birds, you will notice a difference in tail shapes. Tails vary from round, square-tipped, forked, notched, and multi-pointed to wedge-shaped, pointed, long, and short. Recognizing these shapes will help make identification easier. Whether you are identifying a red-breasted nuthatch or a gray-crowned crane, learning bird anatomy will help you in your journey of birding.